بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وصلى الله وسلم على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين وبعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدى محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار وبعد فما زلنا في حديث السابع والحمد لله نحن في خلاصة الشرح لفضيلة الشيخ صالح الفوزان حفظه الله في شرح حديث أبي رقية تميم ابن أوس الداري حيث قال أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال الدين النصيحة قلنا لمن قال لله ولكتابه ولرسوله ولأئمة المسلمين وعامتهم والحديث رواه إمام مسلم رحمنا الله وإياه. We're still reading, alhamdulillah, the hadith number 7 in an Arba'een al-Nawawi, which is the hadith of Abi Ruqayyata Tamim ibn Aws al-Dari. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be pleased with him and all the companions of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we are at the very end of this explanation of Sheikh Salih al-Fawzan hafidhahu Allah wa ra'ah. And this hadith goes, the companion Abi Ruqayyata, which was his kunya, and this is one of their sunan, or the sunan that the people have abandoned today, meaning being ascribed or being called or being any called by the kunya. It is, alhamdulillah, it's very important that you find that all the companions, they used to have kunya. To the point that our mother Aisha radiyallahu anha talabat minan nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that our mother Aisha, she sought from the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to give her a kunya. And even the kids, it is from the sound authentic narrations that they used to have kunya. Like the hadith of the young boy that used to have the bird, Ya Aba Nufair. And the bird, that was the bird name. This was his bird. So the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam called him by his bird. And the bird was beloved to him. So alhamdulillah, hatta the kids, you know, to ask them, hey, for instance, what do you want to name your, what is your favorite name that you will name your son or your daughter? Alhamdulillah, in regard to that, you know, barakallahu feekum, give them a kunya, and also to, alhamdulillah, know one another kunya, and to be, alhamdulillah, using the istimal kunya, using the kunya. Ala ayyin, the hadith of Abi Ruqayyata Tamim ibn Aws al-Dari. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Ad-deenu al-Nasiha, that the religion is sincere advice. Qulna, we said, ayy, the companions, liman, unto whom, lil istihqaq, qala lillahi wa li kitabihi, unto Allah, to his book, to his prophet, wa li a'immatil muslimin, unto the Muslim leaders, وعامتهم, and to the general population of the Muslims. And this is the last point for this hadith, which is the nasiha for the عامتهم, meaning the general folk. Sheikh Salih al-Fawzan hafidhahu Allah, he say, and this is in page 117. He said, حفظه الله تعالى, he said, والنصيحة لعامة المسلمين تكون بالصدق في المعاملة. He said, having sincere advice in regard to the Muslims, to the general population of the Muslims, it is to have a sidq, truthfulness, في المعاملة, in regard to the interaction. Meaning to have truthfulness in how you interact with the Muslims. He say, أَمَّا الَّذِي يَغِشُّ الْمُسْلِمِينَ فِي الْبَيْعِ وَالشَّرَاءِ وَالْمُعَامَلَاتِ فَقَدْ خَانَهُمْ. He say, as the person that is cheating the Muslims in regard to their dealings, whether buying or selling, he is cheating the Muslims. He has indeed betrayed them. وَلَمْ يَنْصَحْ لَهُمْ, and he is not being having a yani truthful nasiha with them, a sincere advice with them. Qala sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the messenger alayhi salatu wa salam, he say, on the hadith akhrajahu imam Muslim min hadith abi hurayrata radiyallahu anhu wa arda, qala sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, man ghashana falaysa minna, whoever cheat us is not from us. Whoever cheat us is not from us. How do you understand this hadith? So we wake the brothers up a little bit. How do you understand this hadith, Abu Asma? Man ghashana falaysa minna. Huh? Ahsanta. That this individual is naqisul iman. Jazakallahu khayran wa ahsanallahu ilayk. That this means that the person that cheat, his iman is deficient. That doesn't mean that he is a kafir. فَلَيْسَ مِنَّا, he is not from us, doesn't mean he is a kafir. But rather it means that his belief is deficient. His belief is deficient. That doesn't mean that he is a disbeliever, عَلَى الْإِطْلَاقِ. But rather here it means that his belief is what? Is naqis, as our beloved brother has mentioned, hafidhahullah. So he mentioned, Shaykh Salih al-Fawzan, hafidhahullah, he say, كَذَلِكَ مِنَ النَّصِيحَةِ لِعَامَّةِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. Likewise, it involved into having sincere advice in regard to the Muslims, the general Muslims in general. He say, دَعْوَتُهُمْ إِلَى اللَّهِ, to call them to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To call them to Allah. So it is not just like you be having a fair deal, a fair trade with them, not cheating, no cheating involved, that's it, la. But rather having nasiha for them is da'watuhum ilallah, calling them to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He say, bida'watihim ila islahi ma indahum minal khalali. And it is to call them to rectification for the mistakes that they have. Right? What is the greatest mistake that the Muslims today they have? What is it? The greatest mistake that the, today the Muslims they have. What is it? Adam? At-tawheed. Right. That's at-tawheed.
Ash-shirk.
Ash-shirk. What else? Abandoning the proper manhaj. Huh? The innovations. I mean, the list goes on and on. All of these are major. All of these are major, barakallahu fi. So that shows also that establishing, calling to Allah has to be established upon what? Upon the asas, upon the fundamental principles, which is at-tawheed. So he mentioned, hafidhahullahu wa ra'ah. He say it is that you have sincere advice in regard to the Muslims, is that you call them to the rectification, مَا عِنْدَهُمْ مِنَ الْخَلَلِ, of that which they have, of mistakes, of errors. وَبَيَانِ مَا يَجْهَلُونَ مِنْ أُمُورِ دِينِهِمْ, and also to clarify those matters that they ignore in regard to their religion. To enlighten them, to educate them in things that they ignore in their religion. طيب. And you all remember the hadith of the hadithu al-musi'u fi salatihi. The one that prayed in the masjid sallallahu, in the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam masjid, and his prayer was what? He was making a lot of mistakes in the salah. Look, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam seeing, he rectified them. He taught him. And the person, he say, وَالَّذِي بَعَثَكَ بِالْحَقِّ, by the one that sent you with the truth. لا أحسن غير ذلك. There is, I cannot do better than this. This is all I can do. فعلمني, teach me. طيب. So the messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he always tell him, go pray back. So it is that you clarify for them that which from the matters that they ignore. ومن نصيحتي لهم أيضا, and also from giving a sincere advice to the Muslims, it is الأمر بالمعروف والنهي عن المنكر. He say it is that you enjoin the good and forbid the evil. But upon what way? Upon what way? Meaning it is not a door that is open for you to enjoin the good and forbid the evil however you want to. But بطرق الشرعية, in the legislative ways. That means that the calling to Allah, it is something that is called what? Tawqifiyya. So one is not to be calling to Allah however he desires. Oh, this method works, so we're going to implement it. Right? Oh, okay, by calling to Allah in this way, let's do a movie about Islam. Maybe it will work. Even if everybody will be guided upon that path, that is not to say that that path is legislated to Allah by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because it is a way that is foreign to how the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his noble companions call to Allah. Right, that's the same line, barakallah, as the comedy show, right? People that, you know, talking, we calling the people by way of, you know, comedy stands and like this. Or this new Dajjal that appear, right? Which is the rap group, what you call it? Deen Squad. May the squad take them away. That would be better for them though, right? Ma'adhiratan. So he mentioned Hafidhahullahu Tabaraka wa Ta'ala wa-nahi anil munkari, but yani enjoying the good and forbidding the evil, but upon the way that is legislated. Amma law turikatil munkar, aw he say as if now, amma law turikati al munkarat wal akhta biduni an tu'alij fahadha min al ghish. He say if the evil and the errors has been left unrectified, he say this is cheating them. If the error and the mistakes are left unrectified, of course by the one that is to be rectifying it, he say hadha min al ghish, this is from cheating them, this is from cheating the people. لكن الإنسان يقول بما يقوم معذرة يقوم بما يستطيع. He say, but the person, he will only establish what he has the ability to do. Nobody asking you to do something you don't have no ability to do. Nobody is asking you to give a fatwa, because that's not your level, right? So the person, he will only do what he is fit to do. He only do what is he is fit to do. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in this very well-known hadith, وَلِلَّهِ الْحَمْدُ وَالْمِنَّ, hadith akhrajahu Imam Muslim on the authority of Abu Sa'id al-Khudri radiyallahu anhu wa arda. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that whoever, and all of us pretty much memorize this hadith, right? But let's add the takhrij of the hadith and we will have it tamaman. The hadith is from Muslim, and it is narrated by the Sahaba, Abu Sa'id al-Khudri. Abu Sa'id al-Khudri, Imam Muslim, right? Abu Sa'id al-Khudri is the companion that heard this from the Messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and this hadith is reported by who? Imam Muslim. He say, whomsoever see any evil among you, we all know this hadith, all of us can continue with this, right? Whomsoever see a munkar, right, a evil, let him do what? Change it with his hands, mouth, heart, right? Heart. Let him change it with his hands. If he doesn't have the ability with his mouth, if he doesn't have the ability with his heart, and he mentioned وَذَٰلِكَ أَضْعَفُ الْإِيمَانِ, with the heart, meaning hating it, is the lowest of iman. As we say that this hadith is also a dalil of what? Huh? Yes, that's a dalil that iman goes up and down. Barakallahu fiqh, ahsanta. This is proof that the iman goes up and down. Barakallahu fiqh. He says, فَأَنْتَ تُنْكِرُ الْمُنْكَرُ بِحَسْبِ اسْتِطَاعَتِكَ, that you rectify the evil to the best of your ability. He say, in kana laka sulta, if you have the power, wal wilayatu, and you have the authority, he say, tunkir.